Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Greetings, dear family, from St. Cyril and Method Cemetery in Rotterdam, New York, where many of our faithful are buried after they have fallen asleep in the Lord. This is Memorial Day weekend here in the United States, and we have on our minds all of those who have offered their lives for the sake of peace and sacrifice to the United States and the armed forces. But we also remember all of our family who have fallen asleep, our mothers, our fathers, husbands, wives, grandmothers, grandfathers, friends, cousins, siblings, anybody connected to us, especially the most poignant. They come to mind on a day like today, on Memorial Day weekend. And we pray for the repose of the souls of all the faithful departed. I'm here in front of the principal mausoleum of the cemetery and praying for dear friends who have fallen asleep in the Lord, that they may rest in peace. This is also a lamentable time here in the world, given the tragedies of the war in Eastern Europe. We wonder before God, how does this happen? And why does it happen? And the mysteries that we hold before the heart of God. How people turn away from peace and turn toward division and encompassing more power, whether it be world leaders or, regrettably, as we've seen the past few weeks, those who seek to wield power by shooting others and killing them, either in the supermarket or in classrooms in Buffalo, New York, or Uvalde, Texas. These are most regrettable situations. May these souls rest in peace. And we need to pray more and more, more closely as the body of Christ, for peaceful solutions to all of our challenges and problems in the world. God desires that we have life and life to the fullest. Yet there is a mystery why young men or young women may tend toward a personalized vision of power by overthrowing and removing people that they see are an obstacle or that they see are a problem. And God came to save all people. All people are loved by the good Lord. Not some. Why is it then that there are some people who turn away from God and turn toward radical groups or a radical vision of something that is completely repugnant to the gospel of Jesus Christ? So I sit here in the cemetery in prayer this day, reflecting on the many blessings that I have been given and certainly that you have been given as well. While in thanks to God, it's a very difficult time in our lives to read or hear the news stories that we are seeing. And I don't mean just economics. That may be a subject for a different day. But on this Memorial Day weekend, we know that many people have recently sacrificed in one way or another. We need to pray for our world more carefully and pray that there is a turn away from violence and destruction and toward building up rather than tearing down. Of course, you and I do not have the answers as to why these tragedies may happen. They are obviously an occasion of prayer for you and I, the Church of Jesus Christ, to continue to pray to God that all may see the light of faith rather than the light of hatred or destruction. And in prayer for one another on this weekend. A difficult time, yet a time that is still in the Easter season. Remember the season that the church is in. Easter is a time of great hope and joy. Yes, joy, even in this time, that you and I can know in our hearts the resurrection of Jesus and what it means for us. That even if we should fall asleep in Him, no matter what the manner or method, that still it is God by his cross and resurrection has promised us a share in the ascension, which is the 40th day of Easter, the ascension of Jesus to heaven, where we hope to be in union with Heavenly Father forever. Even if we should fall asleep, even prematurely, our faith gives us hope that this union with God is possible, no matter the obstacles, or no matter how many people may turn away from the light of the gospel and toward the darkness and toward the violence. That will not be victorious. Only God's will be victorious in the long run. Of course, there are short-run difficulties and obstacles and challenges and hurdles on the road of life. That much we know that we cannot avoid. But in the long run, the vision of the kingdom of heaven, communion with God, there is no pain and no suffering, no matter how hard it hurts here and now. God be with you, and my prayers are with you, dear family, on this Memorial Day weekend. May we remember those who offered their lives as we pray together for peace in our world and peace in our homes. O Mary, conceived without sin, pray for us who have recourse to thee. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, God be with you.